Welcome into Extra Time. Everyone in the studio, plus Mark Ogden and Stewart Robson, still with us. We'll start with Mark, who's in a warm studio for a change. What should United do with Alexis Sanchez, Mark, who hasn't performed for United and is being paid massive wages?
I think you've got to stick with Sanchez because, you know, when he came to the club, he had injuries and he had Mourinho that wasn't really used in the right way. And I do think that he's only 30, he's got the opportunity to prove himself with a second chance. He's had a bad season with injury this year. I do think Sanchez, in their summer, is a player. And, you know, we only saw Arsenal 18 months ago what a great player he can be. So I think they persevere with him. I think if Solskjaer can, you know, use his so-called magic on Sanchez, they've got a player there.
That's a lot of magic, isn't it?
Well, he's got it, apparently.
Yeah, it's a lot of magic,
man,
Paul.
He's a man, he's going to sprinkle the magic dust over Man United and Guardiola will be quaking in his boots.
There's obviously something wrong with Sanchez, physically, because there's no way that he could play as badly as he's played at United. At Arsenal, he was magic. He's fantastic.
Robert, you said he'd be a massive success at United.
Oh, hello.
Yeah, well, I think what he's missing is Arsene Wenger, because obviously Arsene Wenger got the best out of him and he was a top-class manager, better than the people that he's had at Manchester United. That's been the answer to his problem. No Arsene Wenger.
He's only 30.
Yeah, but I got to tell you, it looks like an old 30.
Yeah.
And all this magic that we're talking with Solskjaer, it has sprinkled on everybody else, except Alexis Sanchez, because he still looks very much like he looked under Jose Mourinho. He just doesn't feel... I think he's gotten to a point to where he senses he cannot beat people with the same sort of pace and movement that he did before, and he's struggling to find other ways to be effective.
500,000 a week, is that what he makes?
Well, that's a real struggle.
I think they should try and get rid of him.
Bargain.
Yeah, but who's going to pay that?
If he can, which is going to be difficult now, because you've only got to be better than him in training to go in and ask for 500 grand a week. And that's, and joking aside...
People do that at training, you know? Players would do that?
Joking aside, there's... No. I think that's already caused some problems with new contracts for players. I mean, Mark can correct me if I'm wrong, but there's a bit of a tug of war going on at the moment. I think De Gea is involved in terms of contracts and maybe one or two others, and all their contract demands will probably have been bumped up. Not to that level, but a fair amount.
The big issue is De Gea. I think De Gea has seen that Sanchez is earning 500 grand a week, and De Gea knows how important he is, and he's using that as a lever to get more money. And I think, you know, that could cause United to lose De Gea at the end of the day, because I don't think they'll pay what they're paying Sanchez. I think they have to roll back on that a little bit.
Ogie, what does Pochettino do now that Man United and Real Madrid doors are closed? Will he be allowed to spend big at Spurs?
He won't be able to spend big at Tottenham. That's an absolute definite. I think he stays at Tottenham for a year. Tries to win a trophy, tries to, you know, prove himself to be the next level coach that they can, you know, deliver trophies. But I do think, like I said earlier on, I do think that next summer, 2020, is going to be a big summer for Tottenham. And if Pochettino hasn't been satisfied by their ambition or won something at that point, I think he goes. And who knows, Man United might be available in 12 months' time. Real Madrid probably will be, because it usually is. So the two big jobs that he could have had this summer might be available next summer.
Robbo, if you're setting up your own team, who would you have as the manager, Zidane or Pochettino?
I would have Pochettino. I think he's probably the better coach. Zidane is probably a very good man manager. I don't know him to speak to, but he looks as though he's somebody that got the best out of those Real Madrid players for 2 or 3 years. Then he realised he couldn't manage them any longer. He went away for a little while. I'd go with Pochettino because I think he's the all-round package. I think he knows how to get players. He knows how to coach players. He can manage the board as well. He manages Levy brilliantly, like no other Tottenham manager has done. And he can also manage the players. So
doesn't win trophies, so Robbo.
But he's not at a club that should win trophies that often. Spurs are a second-rate club.
Oh, my goodness. So, wait, so winning Champions League and winning the league, that's not... Is that not enough to put you over the top? No?
Robbo just wants somebody who gets on well with him on the board.
Well, I guess so.
Zidane wouldn't talk to him, that's what we...
But Zidane did great at Real Madrid, but as Robbo said, you kind of... How many players did he buy?
So you take Pochettino over Zidane.
Well,
that's a question.
Yeah. Well, if they were going into a club to rebuild a club, then
no, that's not the question.
Yes,
not to rebuild.
That would
you
was
rather
the question.
Have Zidane or Pochettino? Would you rather have Zidane or Pochettino's manager of your club? That's the question. Not a rebuild. Would you have Zidane or Pochettino?
I'd rather have Pochettino.
All right. Good luck.
Paul, who would you
I'll take the championships.
I'll go with
both. You win championships with Real Madrid?
Because there's no loyalty, I'll go with both of them.
Can Argentina win Copa America 2019? Now, Higuain has retired from Argentina national football. Now, Ali, we spoke to you about this on the show. Mm-hmm. What do you think?
So now that Higuain's retired, they're... Yes.
What's that got to do with
it? Yeah, exactly. Now, what's
well, because it's tongue-in-cheek, isn't it? Because people said that he was an issue as to why they didn't win World Cups in the past.
Well, the thing that we've been saying it for donkey's years, I mean, that Messi is, in my opinion, the best player in the world at the moment. I mean, he's got nobody around him. You know, you can't win the tournaments on your jack, can you? It's impossible.
Mark Ogden, what is the probability of Saul to City? Would he be a Fernandinho or Gundogan replacement?
I think City are ahead of the pack at the moment on Saul, and I think there will be other teams interested, but I think he can be seen as a Fernandinho replacement. Fernandinho's 33, so they do need to find a guy to come in. They've looked at people in the past. They looked at Fred, missed out on him. They're probably lucky there. They've looked at other players, looked at Jorginho, missed out on him. So maybe it's third time looking to get Saul or somebody of a similar calibre, but I think other teams will be interested in Saul Niguez, so City might have it all their own way.
Otamendi fans sending that in. Too many of them. All right, final...
Missed out on Fred, got lucky there. Missed out on Jorginho, got lucky there.
And Sanchez. Right. Okay, Robbo, final question. Who finishes higher in the Premier League table? Huddersfield Town, managed by Pep Guardiola, or Manchester City, managed by me?
Oh, that's easy.
Managed by you.
Well, I've seen you sort of... I've seen your football views on many occasions, Dan, so I would go with... But I still trust you to get the best out of those players.
You think
it
so?
It would be you at Manchester City. Yeah, just about. But you'd have to have a good assistant.
Well, nobody would work with him, though, Robbo.
Is he interviewing for the job? You know, if he was your assistant, he would take over.
Yeah,
right?
I'd be his assistant.
He'd be like, Dan,
yeah.
You go off.
Yeah, that's it.
You could just put your thumb on him, couldn't you? You could put your thumb on him and just rule him and sort of say, I'll take over. I'll give him 6 weeks and get him out.
Wow. He already has a plan to have you fired.
Yeah, mate, that's fair enough.
To be fair, there's a few that you could have a fight with there, though. You know, David Silva.
Yes, yeah, little ones.
Gundogan.
Yeah.
Bernardo Silva.
Yeah.
Gabriel Jesus.
I'd get Jesus Navas back to make me feel better about my height and my crossing.
You know, you'd have to pick your fights here, but there's a few...
I think so, as opposed to Huddersfield. They all look a bit like him.
Steady.
Yeah.
Well, useless.
Pieters.
That's it, we're done. ESPN FC is back tomorrow.
Strange question. Though.
You're off tomorrow.
I am off
Finally.
Tomorrow.
Finally.
I've done some days in a row.
Yay!
Give him a pat on the back. Oh, my goodness.
Liverpool against Spurs. I think Aid's here tomorrow.
All right.
To look ahead to that game.
What could possibly go wrong?